Welcome to a Web Extra. We want to talk about things that are going on right now today as we're taping this. We've got UNM Athletics on the docket with our regents. There are people testifying right now in front of them about the cuts that you know about and the four sports that have been announced. And we're going to see what happens there. But we want to have a discussion, Didi, about all of this. There's a lot of different places we can go here as we sit here. This testimony is going on right now as we sit here. One of the first questions that comes up is why these particular four sports? Because it seems pretty obvious they're not affiliated with the Mountain West Conference. And it seems like this is the low-hanging, easy fruit, and everything just sort of stopped there at the cuts. What's your sense of these cuts?
Well, it certainly seems like it. The low-hanging fruit that is not affiliated with the conferences, and they didn't really have time to respond to all of this.
This is
a new announcement, and my understanding is a lot of people came over there to testify before a vote, whatever the vote would be, but that doesn't make a good public process.
That's right.
Have the people that are affected most by your decisions not really have time to organize, not really have time to say their piece.
That's right.
And I feel bad for them just because football is the be-all and end-all. They're on the short end of the stick and not giving time to respond.
Right, exactly right. As we sit here, Jeffrey, it's just before noon on Thursday. We haven't heard from Eddie Nunez yet, but as Didi mentioned, it was just late yesterday, Wednesday afternoon, these folks got the word. And not a lot of time to prepare. Even the women I heard this morning in front of the regents were saying, we just didn't have time to prepare for this, but here we go. We want to talk about this.
Yeah.
Now, the other thing holding out is the Title IX situation. Does it make sense to you that we would cut the women's beach volleyball team if we have an issue with Title IX numbers here? Something doesn't seem to make sense here.
Well, of course. But I think, again, the bigger question for me is, can a mid-major university like UNM operate in a model that's changed drastically over the last 10 years? There are, I believe, five power conferences. The average budget for their athletic department, take Alabama, $700 million.
Wow.
Oklahoma, maybe it's $300 million.
Sure.
Our budget for the athletic department might be $15 million. The point is the models change because conferences like the SEC, the Big 12, they're getting billion with a B, billion-dollar TV contracts.
That's right.
The Mountain West, not so much. So the model, the very model in which UNM athletic departments engage and operate, particularly basketball and football, it's changed over the last 30 years.
That's right.
And so you have the have-nots, the top five power conferences,
right.
And then you have these mid-level conferences like UNM. I think that's what the conversation hadn't been put forth.
Have we not had a vigorous enough conversation about football, in your view, about eliminating football? Has it really been seriously put on the table? It's been nibbled out of the edges, but we haven't really
put it on
there. It's
difficult for me to say out loud, but I think it's fair. I think it's just. I think it's viable that football should be discussed as something that should possibly be looked at to be eliminated because, correct me if I'm wrong, football is the most cost-intensive sport in all because I think of the roster, 50, 60 plus, and all of that. But attendance over the last, probably three generations has not been very good other than that period.
Three generations.
Well, sorry, Bob Davey, but he's right. You know, winning solves a lot of things. But
let me caveat that.
That's right.
Other than that period where Rocky Long was coach, I think attendance was pretty stimulated then. But over the last 10 years, it's not very good. Why can't we talk about some modification for football? I think it's fair.
It almost seems like, Harry, I hear Jeffrey's point and others like him.
Right.
Like we're held hostage by this Mountain West Conference
thing. Right, yeah.
Like, have we built this thing to the point where if we even go to them and say, look, we can't not do this anymore.
Yeah,
it's not that we don't want to do it. We can't do this anymore. Are they really going to jettison out of everything?
Are they going to take us out when our men's basketball team, is a big driver?
Exactly.
Well, first of all, let's be honest. It's not a great conference. It's not the SEC.
That's right.
It's not the Big Ten.
Right.
And Jeffrey's point, I think, is a really good one. We're talking about 85 scholarships. We're talking about a program that will just never, ever compete with its neighbors. All of our neighbors are, think Oklahoma, Texas, Colorado, Utah, Arizona. We're never going to be competitive. So it's 85 scholarships. It's an enormous revenue, an enormous cost drain. You get rid of football and you just basically dare the Mountain West to say, throw us out of the conference, throw our team out of the conference, and see what happens. And that solves the Title IX problem, and it solves the budget problem.
What do you think of that? It just seems like this football thing is so sacrosanct. It's so, you know, it's so untouchable. It's like, come on, we're
this is
especially sorry to interrupt, but these cuts only get us to 1.15 million in cuts versus 1.9. That's a major gap. That's a huge gap.
I'm having a major struggle with that. Mm-hmm. But I also, as y'all all know, I grew up in football country. Football is sacrosanct where I grew up.
Right.
But I look at this intellectually and I'm going, that doesn't even make sense. And our football team is, they're lovely people, I'm sure. but 85 scholarships, which we have to offset for Title IX, that doesn't even, and then we're going to cut, I don't know what, they have 7, 8, 9 scholarships in the beach volleyball, mm-hmm. but we don't seem to be, in my mind, we're not going in the right direction.
Right.
Mm-hmm. I would, ideal world, I'd like everybody to be great, I'd like football to be a major house player, but it isn't.
Sure.
We can't even compete with New Mexico State,
that's right.
Pardon me.
That's right.
But and make it truly exciting mm-hmm. and our community involved. Basketball is what we do.
That's right.
I agree with you. I don't think they would throw us out because basketball is too important and UNM basketball is too good.
That's right.
Over the years.
I think we're hiding behind this Mountain West thing. I really do. I mean, I'll probably get in trouble this with university people, but I think it's a thing that we have said so many times over and over and over and over. No one's really stopping to think about it and saying, no, wait a minute, we can sit down and negotiate with these people because you can't be forced to keep a sports program that's draining you, you know what I mean? Just because you're gonna lose a conference affiliation, it just doesn't work that way.
Well, what kind of power do these people have
exactly.
in the Mountain West? That's what I wanna know. Can they must be running colleges.
Mm-hmm.
If
mm-hmm.
they are dictating this, are they dictating other mm-hmm. areas?
And who represents UNM on this conference? Leadership.
That's right. We're talking 66 scholarships, Harry, in these four programs versus the 85 you mentioned for school.
Mm-hmm.
And I want to bring another thing. I mentioned beach volleyball. We'll kind of kick that around a little bit. But just to make the point, it is growing. Those young women have made
Absolutely.
A point this morning in that hearing. That is a very fast-growing Olympic sport, but a legitimate sport nonetheless. And to me, at 18 grand a year, under debate, but they say 18 a grand a year, seems like a pretty good bang for your buck.
Absolutely.
Actually, at 18
mm-hmm.
grand. So why are you going to get rid of something that's going to cost you 18 grand? Is that really doing something to pay down 1.9 million?
It's not doing anything to really solve the fundamental problem.
Right.
So we've got to look at what role sports and athletics plays at a university.
Thank you.
We're talking about an enormous amount of money. So, you know, beach volleyball is small potatoes compared to the $3.7 million that students pay in fees for athletics. One of the things the Albuquerque Journal article pointed out this morning mm-hmm. is there's a discussion of taking the Pitt capital payment and transferring it from athletics to Maine campus.
Right.
You've got all the money that goes for scholarships. I think it would be a really interesting exercise to tote up all the real costs associated with athletics and then put it to a student vote and say, you can either have this money toward tuition or other things that relate to the academic mission of the campus, or you can have the athletics program. But to put the data out there, to be transparent, I would be willing to bet, knowing UNM students, that athletics would get voted down.
Why don't we make UNM an Olympic training university in athletics and soccer, beach volleyball.
Sure.
That's become very, and men and women soccer, mm-hmm. swimming.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, why make the focus that this is the best training ground you can get
mm-hmm.
to be an Olympian? We already know that runners, Olympians come and train here because of our climate, our conditions,
That's
our altitude. So let's say, okay, we can never be Alabama.
Right.
I mean, let's just say it. We're not, guys.
Mm-hmm.
First of all, we don't have Bear Bryant, so we'll never be Alabama. But let's change our focus.
That's
let's do something that can make us special.
You know,
I
Jean,
love that.
What's
yeah.
particularly disconcerting to me as a UNM graduate also is the two programs that are looked at to be, I guess, eliminated, mm-hmm. skiing and soccer, are the very two programs that have achieved the height of national recognition.
That's right. That's right.
I think the only championship we have, correct me if I'm wrong, was skiing.
And I think we had a cross country.
There you go. Sorry about that. Sorry about
the cross. We had a good run.
But soccer was a Final Four in a championship team a couple years back.
That's right.
So that's the irony.
That's right.
Is the height of success in athletics.
Winning has to count for something here, right? It has to. That's why we're fielding teams, is to win.
And in a multicultural environment like the University of New Mexico, soccer just fits better than football.
Thank you. Good point there.
Yes, but it's the alumni that are the problem. It seems to me it's the alumni that are the problem. It would be great to put it up for a vote between for the students. What if you put it up for a vote between for the alumni?
I mean, Didi, I think it's an interesting point, but are alumni really happy with where the football program is? If the alumni are just looking at the facts, they can't really see a path for the program to achieve national prominence. If there was a real program in place to think about sports like soccer that have a future and aren't nearly as costly as football, I think the alumni could come around if they had all the information on the table. They have to know the football program isn't going anywhere.
Because, let's be serious. You're talking about, at some point, you'd have to refurbish the football stadium. Do you know what I mean? To make it work for other things. It's not as if just getting rid of football just ends the problem. You're going to have to do all these other things.
Yeah.
One last question here, guys. I want to kick this around, too. What do you think of the premise that perhaps what we're witnessing here is our new president and our new sports AD basically punting this thing to the Regents by saying, we came up a little short on the money. We came up a little short on anything outside of Mountain West Conference. You all deal with it. You all make the hard decisions. What do you think of that, Dave?
Your fault.
Right, exactly.
Your fault.
It is your fault, after all. It's not us. We just came in. It's sort of like Mayor Keller with art.
That's right.
We just came in here. Mm-hmm. I doubt that, but it certainly doesn't look good with such a short time frame from the decision what they want to do and then handing it to the Regents. And I'm not sure if there's a timeline that they're trying to meet here for funding from the state or what?
That's a point.
Exactly.
Interesting point there. Yeah, because Mo Maestas, Representative Maestas, has been talking about perhaps our economy's picking up a little bit here in the state. Maybe we should give a year grace period here. Let's think about this for a little while and just look at the finances. Does that make sense to you as well? He's calling for a bit of a pullback here.
Cliches, but isn't that kicking the can down the road? I don't know.
Yeah. Yes.
But I will say this. Mm-hmm. If UNM Athletic Department hasn't made budget for the last 8 to 10 years,
that's
by the way, some of this was exaggeration of attendance at football games, things like that, which I understand.
And that too.
Then where were the, with all respect, the Board of Regents being more or not being as vocal 7 years ago, 6 years ago, 5 years ago? Yep. Isn't part of their job respectfully submitted to be the stewards of overseeing some of those finances? Mm-hmm. So I think part of this is, and there's plenty of blame to go ubiquitously all over the room here, but I don't know that the Board of Regents were vocal enough 5 years ago, four years ago, saying, hey, there's a hemorrhage going on here called UNM.
And there was plenty of reporting at the time.
Yeah, but,
on it. They weren't in the dark.
But they still knew that in the mind of the public, that wasn't being dealt with.
Right. Good point. Let's see what happens. They're still talking. We're still monitoring. We'll talk about this more, of course, next week on New Mexico in Focus. See you then.